So what we're going to do next is we're going to head off into apps. We're going to build a summary actually. So click on summary and we'll say create new summary. So now we'll say sales data warehouse and we'll say create application. And we'll pick the sales info table. And this time we'll pick the customer number and the ship year and ship month, and then the field we want to aggregate, month to date sales. So in our case here, because we're aggregating this month to date sales, we'll say we want it to sum it instead of averaging it, which would be the other option. And since this is going to be a new field in the dictionary, we're going to give it a new name with a new length. Oop, I've done the wrong field there. We want month to date sales. Put all that back. Even if you make a mistake, you can just cancel that and come right back to where you were, repick the field. So don't feel like if you're like me, made a mental mistake there, you can just as easily come back and be able to pick up right back where you left off. So we'll make that sum, put an S on there, make it a new field name, give it a length. Great. So in our case now, what we're telling summaries and dimensions is what combination of fields have to be different for a new row to be printed. So in other words, every time the customer number, the ship year, and the ship month change, print that row. So basically, in other words, to the table. So what this is saying is there should only be one record for every unique combination of customer, ship year, and ship month. So we'll go ahead and build that app. Now summaries, data warehouse objects, give us a moment in time snapshot. So in other words, what's going to happen is once this is created, the data will never change in it until it's run again. So if I go ahead and I run this, so it found 3,600 records and it brought it down into 480. And that makes sense, I think, because what that's saying is there's 480 unique rows of customer, month, and year.